of God our Father, and the Lord Jesus Christ, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, we gather in this sacred place for this solemn ceremony of taking these two lives and molding them into one. Brian and Megan have found a love for each other as a reflection of God's enduring love for each one of us. And so we ask you now to be present in these sacred duties as we join these lives together. Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness pour out your grace on these, your servants, Megan and Ryan, that coming together before your altar, they may be confirmed in love for one another through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for the reading.
Reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of the ground various wild animals and various birds of the air, and he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be its name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds in the air, and all the wild animals, but none proved to be a suitable partner for the man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep on the man, and while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, "This one, at last, is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman. For out of her man, this one has been taken. This is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them become one body." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Into the world so that we might have life through him. In this is love,
Not that we have loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as expiation for our sins. Beloved, if God so loved us, we also must love one another. No one has ever seen God, yet if we love one another, God remains in us, and his love is brought to perfection in us. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Celebration, let me remind you that we weren't the first on the wedding guest list. In fact, the first person on their list was our Blessed Lord himself. They decided to be married here, in this sacred place. They decided that their marriage would start with our Lord taking their two lives and molding them into one. As you know, in today's society, there are many options of where and how to be married. But they decided to invite that roaming rabbi named Jesus to their celebration. The same one that went to that wedding feast at Cana in Galilee so long ago, whose mother interceded for that bridegroom to be sure that their wedding celebration was right. And now to Ryan and Megan, our Blessed Lord has accepted your invitation. Through his most unworthy priest, in just a few moments, we receive your wedding vows. 27 words, so ancient, so powerful, from the depths of their hearts, that God in this high heaven will still to listen and will do as they ask as they give their lives to each other. And so the real homily is about to begin. Not my words, that pales in comparison to what they're about to do, to exchange their vows, their lives, and their love. And so to Ryan and to Megan, may the love with which you join your hands and your hearts today grow richer and deeper and stronger every day of your life. And may you now begin a homily of love for all the world to see. God bless. My dear friends, Megan and Ryan, you come together in this church so the Lord may seal and strengthen your love in the presence of the church's minister in this community. Christ himself is present. He abundantly blesses this love. He's already consecrated you in baptism, and now he enriches and strengthens you by a special sacrament so that you may assume the duties of marriage in mutual and lasting fidelity. And so in the presence of Holy Mother Church, I ask you now to state your intentions. Megan and Ryan, have you come here freely without reservations to give yourselves to each other in marriage?
No.
Will you love and honor each other's man and wife for the rest of your lives?
No.
Will you accept children lovingly from God and bring them up according to the law of Christ and his bride, the church?
No.
Since it is your intention to enter into marriage, face each other, join your hands, and declare consent before God and his church.
I, Ryan, take you, Megan, to be my wife.
I promise to be true to you.
I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you.
I will love you and honor you.
All the days of my life.
All the days of my life.
I, Megan, take you, Ryan, to be my husband. I promise to be true to you.
In good times and in bad.
In sickness and in health.
I will love you and honor you
all the days of my life.
You have declared your consent now before the church. May the Lord in his goodness strengthen your consent and fill you both with his blessings. What God has now joined, men must never divide. Lord, bless and consecrate Ryan and Megan in their love for each other. May these rings be a symbol of true faith in each other and in you, and always remind them of their love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Megan, take this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Ryan, take this ring
as a sign
of my love and fidelity. And in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Ladies and gentlemen, by God's grace, Mr. and Mrs. Ryan Patrick Gerson, kiss the bride. Please stand up for our praise and faith. Now that we have heard God's word in the Bible and experienced his powerful presence in this beautiful exchange of vows, let us present these prayer petitions for people in our world today.
For all members of the church, that they may grow more faithful in their commitments to God and to each other, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all leaders of government, that they may be effective in achieving peace, eliminating poverty by striving for a greater spirit of solidarity among all peoples, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For married persons, that they may continue to grow in love, be able to forgive, and find happiness with the passing of each day, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Megan and Ryan, that they may have divine assistance in every moment and the constant support of friends and family, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are ill, that they may be strengthened by God's help, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially for relatives and friends of Megan and Ryan, that they may enjoy perfect happiness and total fulfillment in eternal life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Heavenly Father, your Son Jesus taught us to ask, to seek, and to knock. We have just done so, confident that you will look upon our many needs, consider our trusting faith, and in your great love grant these requests which we make in Christ our Lord. Amen. As the gifts of bread and wine are brought forward to the bride and groom, we ask you kindly be seated.
Thank you.
are redeemed, holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy therefore these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Yeah.
I know, I already know.
Thank you.
Let us stand and pray. Having been made partakers at your table, we pray, O Lord, that those who are united by the sacrament of marriage may always hold fast to you and proclaim your name to all the world through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. This wedding mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord.